Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Dear brothers, sisters, campaigners, those who are standing for justice, I'm not going to take a lot of time because most of the things that needs to be said has already been said. But I was asked to sort of remember at the beginning what it was, and I think it's really important. I remember as it was almost yesterday when we all heard about Guantanamo. We saw those vivid photographs, you know, if you remember, you know, people being shackled, tied and bound to the bottom of the planes with the American flags hanging. And, you know, the barbaric sort of way that they were being moved. And I remember at the time thinking that, my God, we don't even do this to animals. You know, when we transport sheep and cattle, we actually care for their well-being while they're being transported across Europe or within the continent. What is this all about? And it was very clear, even at that time, that the issue was more than just arresting and holding these guys without trial, without any sort of court, or as has been said, a black hole from a legal perspective. But it was there to actually demonize them, dehumanize them, and actually show to the rest of the world that United States not only is going to behave in this way, but is actually proud of it and actually turning it into some sort of patriotic sort of image. You know, and it did become, I mean, shortly after that you could see Americans actually having these photographs around, and it was a sign of how patriotic they are. That, you know, these acts of barbaric acts, behavior towards innocent people became that sort of image. And indeed, you know, I remember very clearly I was getting phone calls from people saying, don't you dare get involved in doing any campaign. These are actually terrorists. These are etc. These are Wahhabis. These are Salafis. These are terrorists. These are the ones who committed. There is no smoke without fire. And some people were actually even were worried to say these on the phone. They were actually coming, knocking at the door and saying, I wanted to say something to you, but I don't want to really say it on the phone. You shouldn't really get involved in this. And unfortunately, many of those were from the Muslim community, and even more so from Muslim community than others. And, you know, I'm saying that particularly because I think we should remember those who immediately stood up. And Karen and Vanessa were among those who actually immediately took the burden on their shoulder and actually organized the Guantanamo Human Rights Commission, and tirelessly, you know, going around within Britain with Muslims there and indeed across the world. I remember traveling to United States. We were all going, there were a number of lawyers from the Guantanamo detainees and some of the members of the family, and we were going to States. I couldn't go with everybody else. I went the day after. And everybody had lawyers there to actually make sure that we could actually get into the United States. And unfortunately, I didn't have that that support. When I got there, the immigration officer sort of looked at my British passport and said, what's the purpose of your visit? I said, I've come here to release the Guantanamo details. You should have seen the shock on his face until I actually showed some of the documentation. But, you know, really, we need to recognize that. And also, we need to recognize, even at that time, I did receive other phone calls. I received a phone call from Ahmad Qasim, who himself spent 11 years in Robben Island as a prisoner. And he phoned me and he said, make sure, and he actually said, make damn sure that you are going to stand and support not just those who are detained, but but the families. Make sure they are not going to be demonized in the community. Make sure that you become their friends and create a whole network of support around them. And this is really important now as well. Because really, we've got many others, not just 171 who are in Guantanamo, but many others who are in a similar position. And you know, those who in this country have been put under control orders, etc., you know, imprisoned in their own house, that actually in some ways is much worse than being in actual prison. Many detainees have told me that in South Africa and elsewhere. We need to make sure that they are not demonized on top of that. We need to be there. But one other thing I want to sort of say, thank God, because of all the campaign that has gone out, no one else is going to be going to Guantanamo. That is actually a victory. And also is a victory to see many of ex-detainees here. And, you know, the wonderful friendship that we have had since they have been released. If I'd known they were such a nice people, probably I would have worked harder to release them. But, you know, the reality is that we need to continue that campaign. But also I want to say a word of warning. The new policy of the United States is not just close Guantanamo because it was unacceptable. The new policy is that you don't arrest them anymore. You just target them and send a drone in and kill them, and kill their neighbors, kill their family, and kill their loved ones. And you know, the reality is that we don't even hear the names of those who are being targeted. We can't even campaign for them to be returned home because they're dead and gone, and we don't even know who they are. We need to campaign against that policy. And we need to make sure that those are not forgotten. And the reality is that the drones are killing, all the reports highlight, 75% of so-called innocent people. I would say 100% innocent people, because none of them have been found guilty in any courts of law. And we need to campaign on that. Let us take the momentum of this for two things. One, a commitment that we will make sure all 171 will be returned to their loved ones. And secondly, go with a vigorous campaign against this new policy of assassinating those who are no more guilty or less guilty than those who are in Guantanamo and are free now with us, among us. And that should be a promise. And let us rise up to that challenge. Thank you very much.